Rise and shine, family. Listen, I just want to talk to you guys a little bit about what my life's been like the last few months. Anyway, and many of you guys know I went vegan a little over a year ago just to try to be healthier, you know, and all that good stuff. Well, I began to do that, began to get tremendous results, losing weight so quickly. Many of you guys probably remember me posting about it, you know, just posting about, you know, how excited I was to see the weight come off and how much better I felt. My son actually was cured from asthma. I always struggled with, you know, running, doing anything that would exert any type of energy. And he doesn't deal with that anymore at all. So I was always excited about that. I'm very excited about that, of course. I posted about how I was so excited that I healed my son through diet change, you know. Well, shortly after that, I learned that I had a cancer gene. I learned this through my sister getting terminally ill and passing away. And on her deathbed, you know, we talked about, you know, getting checked to see if we had the same, you know, if it was genetic. Because my mother died in the same way, the same exact cancer. When she was 33, I was 3. My sister was 44. So we did get checked, and 4 out of 5 of her children did have the cancer gene. In fact, me being one of them, of course. My older sister, now that my older sister had passed away, so now my current older sister, she already had cancer, so she had to have her stomach removed. My niece did the same. And of course, now I've had to do it, and here we are. You know, I was a little bit excited too soon, I should say, after I got this surgery. I posted, a picture saying, you know, how strong I still felt, and you know how the surgery wasn't gonna be, you know, the end of me. And you know, right after that is when the actual process of my stomach of now, because they take your actual esophagus and connected to your lower intestine, making that your new stomach. So it takes a while for your stomach to adjust, your now new stomach to adjust. So man, it's just been hard to eat for a while. I couldn't get anything to go down, not even water. Not even the tube formula that was going inside the feeding tube was helping. Everything was so painful. It's still hard for me to eat, guys. I'm still having to eat tube formula, whether it be, you know, by blending it with my fruit and veggies that I eat and different types of things, as I'm no longer on the feeding tube that was removed. But needless to say, guys, I ended up losing so much weight. I left out of the hospital at 208 pounds. And I'm sorry, I went in at 208 pounds, left out at 197. And within a matter of a month's time of my stomach trying to adjust, I went from that to around 150, feeling so weak, hard to have energy and all. But you know, either which way, it's really been a tough time. I managed to get up and go to Dallas to hang out with Jamar Milton and the family, the Lighthouse family, you know, and be a part of that event there. And it was amazing. That has given me I would say some new energy to really get healthy, guys. I miss you guys. I want to get back out here. I just want to say, you know, a lot of people think that this is because I left religion. It's just not, guys. It's just not. You have to understand, man, there are so many Christians that are in my family. In fact, I am the only one that is non-religious, okay? The other ones had the same issue, okay? And they are all Christian. My sister was Christian and she died. You know, my mother was Christian and she died of the same issue. This would have happened long before I was born. My mother had this in her DNA whenever I was born. So it's not because I walked away from religion, guys. We have to think deeper than that. All right. So I know a lot of people are rooting for me to fail simply because I walked away from religion. But listen, guys, do not count me out. I'm stronger than you think. And I will be back. I will be back stronger than ever. Believe me. This is now one thing down that I don't have to worry about creeping up on me. My sister was 44. Listen, I'm 36 years old. I didn't want to have to worry about it. They already found problems inside of my stomach lining anyway. I could not take any risks, so I had to deal with it. It was harder than I expected, Would I have been so quick to do it again, knowing now what I would go through? I wouldn't say so, but I guess it's good that I didn't, because now it's done. All right. That being said, family, be the evolution. Be evolution. Be the change you want to see. And no candle loses its flame from lighting another. And I want to say thank you guys to all of you who came alongside and helped me, and is still helping me during this time. Times have been hard. There have been times where I couldn't even get the food that I needed to remain healthy. But a lot of you guys have been contributing, and I really appreciate it. I just want to say I'll never forget it, guys. I really will not ever forget that. So I really appreciate it. I love you all. Peace.